Welcome back, Masterclass members. Let me continue to talk about chronic adult and senior knee joint pain. It is part 6. You may have noticed that I have different perspectives from ordinary doctors. Before starting the lecture, I want to show people's common opinions about senile knee pain. To prove the general consensus, I have asked two text-based chat AIs for information. Chat AI is designed to communicate with humans through written messages, using natural language processing algorithms to generate real-time responses based on the context and information provided. While the answers provided by AI are based on common knowledge, it's important to remember that they may not always be correct and might be influenced by societal norms and biases. First, I asked AI about the cause of the pain of osteoarthritis. It answered, "Osteoarthritis is a condition in which the protective cartilage on the ends of bones wears down over time, leading to pain and inflammation in the affected joints. The pain of osteoarthritis is usually due to the wear and tear of the joint, but can also be caused by inflammation of the joint and the irritation of the nearby nerves." Second, I asked OpenAI GPT about the prevalence of meniscal tears and whether they are more common in young people than seniors. The AI responded that meniscal or cruciate ligament tears are more commonly observed among younger individuals than seniors. The second AI provided the same answer, suggesting that the higher prevalence of meniscal tears in young people is likely due to increased intensity of physical activity, which can increase the risk of injury. Based on the information provided by AI, it is still common for many doctors to hold onto the conventional belief that meniscal or cruciate ligament tears are more prevalent among younger individuals than seniors. Next, I asked the AI to provide information on the incidence of meniscal tears in different age groups. Again, the AI provided the result. It is known that the incidence of meniscus tears increases with age due to degenerative changes in the knee joint. The playground is often where young athletes are most prone to injury. Conversely, violent sports activity is often when young individuals are most commonly injured. However, seniors' risk of injury persists throughout their lives. Any time and any place. Additionally, the degeneration of tissues can leave them more fragile and susceptible to injury. After that, I asked the same question to the OpenAI GPT. It says, "I apologize for the confusion. Based on the statistics I provided earlier, the prevalence of meniscal tears increases with age. Therefore, seniors have a higher incidence of meniscal tears than younger individuals." Now, you would say meniscus tears are more common in older adults due to age-related wear and tear on the knee joint. As people age, the meniscus becomes more brittle and prone to tearing. Many doctors still believe that degenerative osteoarthritis occurs primarily in adults and stubbornly pursue classifying osteoarthritis into early, intermediate, and advanced stages. They are not interested in investigating other potential pathologies in the degenerated senior knee. Now, you would seek specific types of pain generators in the degenerated adult knee, such as a meniscal tear, cruciate ligament tear, subchondral bone marrow edema, etc. Among conventional doctors, intra-articular injection is the only option for interventional treatment of painful osteoarthritis, either steroid, hyaluronic acid, or PRP. Also, when a joint effusion is present, the only question that may be asked is whether or not to aspirate fluid. Interventionists are only the doctor to consider joint effusion as a flag of intractable knee pain, and recurrent effusion may indicate the presence of underlying pathologies such as subchondral bone marrow edema, posterior root tear, or accelerated osteoarthritis. Interventionists have more roles in adult chronic knee pain than other healthcare providers. Once more, I will show the prevalence of meniscus tears. Again, the prevalence of meniscal tears is notable, particularly among individuals over 80 years of age, with a 56% incidence in men and 49% in women. Furthermore, the prevalence of medial meniscal tears tends to increase with age. The incidence of anterior cruciate injury also increases with age. We have studied many contributing pathologies to knee pain in adults. As a result, it is important to consider various types of pathologies as potential sources of pain during the pain assessment. I will now discuss my interventional treatment strategies for chronic adult knee pain. My goals and injection targets for chronic adult knee pain are as follows: to inject as close as possible to the pain generator, to select spaces that have a lot of nociceptors or passage of sensory nerves, to cover all the pain generators as much as possible, to select spaces that hold the injectant longer, and to infiltrate into the free or less resistant space. Regarding prolotherapy, it acts as a tissue expander and does not involve anastomosis of the ends of the tears. I will explain each logic one by one. The first is making injection targets as close as possible to the pain generator. The second is the select spaces with many nociceptors or passage of sensory nerves. The first and second goal look similar but different. These structures could be the pain generators of chronic adult knee pain. For example, we must first find the pathologic meniscus, either medial or lateral meniscus. Then, localize the area of the tear and the type of tear. So, the target should be close to the pathologic area of the meniscus. After finding the subchondral bone marrow lesion, we must find the pathologic area, either the tibia or femur, and its specific location. Then, make a target for the reasonable area for the pathologic area. How do I select the target close to the pathology? Intra-articular injection. Intra-articular injections are most commonly used to manage symptoms associated with knee joint osteoarthritis, and they typically target the synovial lining and hyaline cartilage lining of the joint. While they may not reach the peripheral portion of the meniscus, intra-articular injections can still be used to target the central aspect of the meniscus to manage meniscal tears and related symptoms. It is important to note that intra-articular injections may not be able to deliver medication to structures outside of the joint, such as the cruciate ligament, subchondral bone marrow lesion, and deep collateral ligament structures. Therefore, additional treatment options may be necessary to address the issue depending on the specific condition and affected structures. So, comparing intra-articular infiltrations of a placebo, steroids, hyaluronic, and PRP for knee osteoarthritis does not look smart. It is also disputing the steroid effectiveness in knee osteoarthritis after administering drugs in the intra-articular route only wastes time. I recommend you only accept the concept of each medicine's mechanism and area of action. Also, my point is targeting the injection into a specific group of pain generators, not just a single structure. So, for example, if the pain generator is a meniscal tear, I also focus on the injured peripheral meniscus and meniscotibial and meniscocapsular ligament. If the pathology is the cruciate ligament, I must also deliver the medicine close to the pathologic area. The anterior cruciate ligament attaches from the anterior intercondylar area of the tibia to the posterior lateral condyle, so my injection has to cover all the areas of the anterior cruciate ligament by selecting reasonable targets. I will continue to medial meniscus. Please stay tuned. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.